Hello and welcome back to Pacific Drive. I'm going to do the first mission here. I did start it last time I played, but I got 10 minutes in and I had to go and you can't save it during the mission. So I'm just going to get it started. I'm not sure how long it will take, but this whole episode will be the entire mission. Anyways, thanks for watching.
Okay, newbie. I'll keep this simple. Don't want to overwhelm that little brain of yours. You'll need a few things to rebuild the antenna at the garage. First on the list is plasma. The woods are littered with plasma generators. Look for a research trailer or a spark tower. That's those antenna things zapping you when you get too close. Both are always accompanied by plasma generators.
The arc device is picking up on some plasma generators nearby. Your headset has a built-in scanner. Use it on the plasma generator, and it'll figure out the tools you need.
Yeah, long press C to assign it to a slot. Otherwise, it just assigns its own slot.
Find those materials by any means necessary. No one's coming back ever again, so go on and take what you need. Transports, homes, outposts, facilities, they've all been abandoned since the zone was decommissioned in 87. Most of those structures won't even be there the next time the instability scrambles the area. So loot to your heart's content. Just loot away.
Yeah, once you get used to everything, the menus work really well. Even for crafting.
So fast, don't they? And I'll be back at the helm. Been a long time, old gal. Didn't think we'd talk again after that whole Sasquatch incident.
Yes, I was hoping to go another decade without hearing your voice again. What did you finally talk Francis to death?
Hello to you too, Oppie. And no, I'm still here.
My first playthrough, there was no radiation here, so at least things vary every time you play.
I promise. They deserve to know what they're getting into.
Fine. I'm giving you 60 seconds.
That is not nearly enough time to get...
55 seconds and counting.
Okay. The remnants, in short, they're old objects that do all sorts of weird things. They bind themselves to people, and you're the latest victim. You and the car are inseparable now, so get acquainted. Once the remnant is bound to someone, they become gradually more obsessed with it. It takes over the victim's mind until they go crazy and run off into the zone with it. No one has ever been able to resist its siren call. That fixation is probably worming its way into your brain as we speak. This is the first time we've ever got our hands on one. But we know all about the past remnants, and oh gosh, this one time it materialized as an old copper kettle, and the tea that came out of that thing, it was...
And now I'm splitting the transmissions going to your receiver. Anything critical to your immediate needs will broadcast directly and immediately to your radio and headset. Anything not mission critical will be on a low priority frequency. Those transmissions will be recorded and indexed for you to listen to at your leisure. And by low priority, I mean just about everything that comes out of Tobias's mouth.
I do wonder if you ever get to upgrade your storage or carry a backpack for more storage on yourself too. Okay, I gotta time that right. Stop being so stupid. As I probably proceed to get electrocuted again.
those plasma generators. Look for glowing containment units scattered about in the woods or at the base of the Spark Tower anomalies.
Well, at least only one more time. That time was better.
Well, it looks like you're near one of the old guerrilla radio stations. That ought to be prime pickings for antenna parts. I've loaded its approximate location to your map. Look for an antenna tower up on a hill somewhere.
My, where are our manners? Driver, we never introduced ourselves. Not really. Tobias Barlow, former Artem maintenance manager. Oh, and here with me is Dr. Francis Cook.
I was a R&D scientist researching limb technology right here in the zone.
We live right in the mid-zone. Just a hop, skip, and a jump over another big old wall from where you're at. Oh, and that old bat over there? That's Dr. Ophelia Turner, former director of research and development herself. The mother of limb technology, the maven of electromagnetism.
That's enough.
Resident party pooper.
I was hoping I could grab that, but I don't think I can. got out to close the open passenger door, but it was already shut after I closed mine. I thought for sure it was going to go across the road. May as well make sure that can is full. I don't know how long this mission will take. Not gonna mess with that other car. That magnetic guy is a little too close to it.
Radio stations up on a hill somewhere. Eyes to the horizon.
Now all I need is a nice set of rims and this thing will be worth $1 million. I don't think that's the tower over there. I'll just take a quick peek over there. If that's not it, I'll just cut that part out. No, that wasn't it. Just a bunch of mud that slowed me down. I think I saw my battery gauge go up while my car was getting zapped there. I'll check that out in a future one. I don't want to risk losing 30 minutes of progress here on this quest. Hopefully that wasn't that magnet picking up my car. I left it in a dumb spot, probably. Looks like it's okay. Just realized I'm supposed to scan one. Of course, I didn't do one of the easy ones. At least I didn't get electrocuted. getting a little nervous playing this long with no save. So I don't want to spend too much time hacking apart too many more cars just in case something happens and it costs me.
Time to get moving. The instability's ticking up by the second. But you can't get back the way you came. The instability makes all routes one way. And that's where my arc device comes into play. It'll get you back to the garage, but it needs to be charged first. And to do that, you'll need anchors. Take a look at the arc device display. It maps all anchors in the nearby area. Find an anchor and feed it to the arc device to charge it. But don't you worry your pretty little head about how it works. You'll be out of here soon, so there's no reason to learn more about limb technology than you need to know.
Keep thinking, the way you're helping our friend here right now seems positively helpful. Seems like me. You're looking to turn a new leaf or something?
The only thing I want to look at is a 12-year-old whiskey. And the back of this breacher's head when I sent them packing.
But isn't it worth taking a detour to run just a tiny little test?
Can't think of a worse way to spend my time.
Please. I've seen you manipulate waveforms with your right hand and knock back a double with your left. Or am I to understand you've lost your touch?
What I'm understanding is that you won't shut the hell up until I test this remnant.
Yep.
Fine. Stop crowding my frequency.
What? Wait, really? Oppie, darling, you've never given this easily. What's going on?
Francis?
Yes?
How have you not thrown him to the bunnies by now?
Hey, 80 years old.
Those anchors may look like glowing balls of magic, but it's limb tech through and through.
Don't be scared. They haven't exploded in anyone's face recently.
I thought I could sit in my car, then put it in.
The arc device is charged and ready. You'll use it to open a gateway back to the garage, but it will immediately collapse the stability around you. So only activate when you're absolutely ready to leave. You do not want to get caught in the storm that follows.
Wow, those pillars sure do a number on you. I think I drive to those. I'm beating the crap out of my car anyway. Now, did they turn red because I got too close? I'm not 100% sure. I've never seen this before. Okay, I thought maybe I picked it up, but maybe I'm just too close. Oh yeah, too close. I should have moused over it sooner. There we go.
You see that glowing pillar into the sky? Drive into it. Yes, it looks like hot death, but it's so much better than getting scrambled by the instability. That gateway would. Did I not mention that you're the first human I've sent through that thing? I mean, there have been rodents, but it's not like it's completely untested.
Anyway, it worked. So, you should have made it back with everything you collected out there. That's the beauty of the gateway. It's the only way to get back with all your marbles intact. Now, take those parts you found into the back room. I'll let you use my fabrication station. For now. That station will concoct ways for you to rig up anything from roof racks to flare guns. Assembling an antenna with those parts you brought back should be easy as pie. But it requires anchor juice to work its magic, so bring back as many as you can. And just because I haven't used that garage in decades doesn't mean you can trash the place. Mess up my equipment and I'll throw you to the anomaly so quick you'll get whiplash. We clear?
I like the voice acting in this game, it's pretty good. And nice, I guess this is like a tech tree unlock type thing. And yes, it would have been quicker to go out the other door. Okay, I guess I get to do some car upgrades now too. I'll just keep this in the video. It's gonna be a long one. Sorry about that.
Make sure to empty your trunk before heading back out. You'll need the space. Shape, more or less. I've hooked up the antenna to the route planner. Give it a look after you're done peeping through my garage. Thank you.
I guess if I leave parts lying around anywhere, that just pulls it all in and spits it out. I need to make sure I turn my headlights off before I charge it for the last time before I head out too. Pretty sure that's why my battery's going down a little bit. Yeah, my lights are still on. Anyways, I'm gonna wrap this one up here. If you made it this far, thanks for watching. And I'll see what mission 2 is like. Anyways, take care.